Silk farmers made the plea while addressing MPs on the Presidential Affairs Committee.
Take your presence for granted.
They were in Shema District to visit silk and other government projects. Silk farmer Dr. Elioda Tumwesije, who is also a former Member of Parliament and Minister, suggested government should buy land in different parts of the country and establish silk projects.
Railing houses, that's a cost-limiting step. You find maybe railing houses more than 10 million, and many farmers cannot support that. And then ensure that because now you have got a demand and you are fulfilling a demand, it means even farmers who are engaged in the sector have where to sell their produce. So once the farmers start earning money from their produce, then the sector will be self-sustained.
Shema RDC Frank Cherere noted that factories would increase market for silk farmers in the district and other parts of the country.
As the community, first of all, we are going to have outgrowers of mulberry. This mulberry will be bought by either the factory owners, which is Twiggy, and then they use the mulberry for making thread for silk cloth. That means that our outgrowers will get money from their gardens. And here at the factory, definitely we shall have workers to work in the factory. Mainly technical, and some who may not be so technical, because those ones to manage the cocoons will be from the community here.
Responding to leaders' call, Jessica Ababiku, the committee chairperson, promised that the government is committed to empowering the local community so they can earn more from what they produce.
Because if this project is left at this stage, it means that all the early investments are going to be wasted. We will also recommend that this site becomes our model site, because it is the best performing site, and we'll be able to regularly come and check on its performances and report to the House.
Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.